Several weeks ago, we posted a teardown video of the original Switch charging dock. You can click that right corner to check that. And today we're going to take apart the charging dock of the Switch OLED model. Compared with the old one, this dock has an Ethernet port instead of a USB 3.0 port. And the logo on the front of the dock is smaller, which can easily judge the model. Two USB-A ports are on the side, and the middle slot is used to place the switch. The back of the dock is designed with a small notch to arrange the cables, and all ports are on the right side. It comes with USB-C, HDMI, and Ethernet ports, and the specs info are printed on the rubber pad at the bottom. It supports 15V 2.6A input and 15V 1.2A output, and has passed multiple standards. The dock size is about 175x104x49mm, and the weight is about 286 grams. After having a brief introduction, let's continue to take it apart and check what's inside. First, remove the screws and the cover. A PCB is on the lower right corner for connecting and video converting. It can also provide power, peripherals, and Ethernet for the switch. Remove the cover at the bottom, and we found that the switch is connected to this PCB module through a flat cable. Take out the module. All ports are on the front with metal shields, and the indicator light is connected to the PCB through red and black wires. Here is the connection socket for the USB-C connector inside the dock. Except for those 5 ports, the buck converter, filter capacitor, and hub controller are also on the front. Two USB-C controllers, an MCU, memory, and other chips are on the back. Two synchronous buck converters from Texas Instruments are on the front. The first one supports 70V input and 1A output, model is TPS62150, while the second one supports 70V input and 3A output, model is TLV62130A, same as the original dock. Those two MOSFETs are connected in series and used for power supply control of the USB-C port. The solid capacitor is used for output filtering, 220 microfarad, 10 volts. The USB hub controller is also from VLabs, same model as the original dock. It can control two USB-A ports and Ethernet ports and has low standby power consumption. The Ethernet controller is from Realtek, which is a USB 2.0 conversion chip. Here are the crystal oscillator and step-down inductor of the Ethernet controller. A video conversion chip is under the metal shield, which is also from Realtek and can convert DP to HDMI. As mentioned, this is the connector of the indicator light. The USB-C controller is from ROHM, marked with D92B17. Another USB-C controller is marked with M92T55. And here are some MOSFETs for power supply control. The built-in MCU is from STMicroelectronics, used to control the entire dock. It integrates an M0 core and 128GB flash. And the external crystal oscillator of the MCU is under it. The MCU also has an external memory. Two current limit switch ICs for USB-A are from ROHM. They can protect two USB-A ports from overcurrent. It also integrates a low impedance MOSFET, and the current limit is adjustable from 0.2 to 1.7A. The synchronous step-down converter is from Texas Instruments and adopts SOT563 package. It supports 5.5V input and 1A output. This is a resettable fuse. As mentioned, this is the connection socket for USB-C connector inside the dock. Let's continue to remove 4 screws that fix the USB-C connector. It's supported by springs inside. The USB-C connector adopts the full pin design and is fixed on a small PCB. Remove 2 screws on both sides. And the through-hole soldering can make it more durable. The indicator light is soldered on a small PCB and connected by wires. Well, that's all components of the charging dock of this Switch OLED model. It changes the USB 3.0 port to an Ethernet port, making the network connection more stable. Most of the chips inside are the same as the original dock, but the model and number of some chips have changed. You can also click the corners to check the teardown of the original Switch charging dock. And that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!